speak to anybody, but if you're not man enough to like follow by what you say and say that you're gonna follow when you get out of this fucking house and you see how much I've been riding for you and Shayna, it makes me wanna like burst into tears because I was honest with Cynthia and Carson when I left their side. I've been honest with you. And the moment that we said that man to man, like conversation right here in this very room, I was riding for you. And I was like, in my mind, we had the power and the numbers to make it top four. I fought for Shayna to be in this group with Misha more than you did. And you're closer friends with her. Like, I've been like being so honest and trustworthy with everybody in this house. I feel like I've played the most transparent game. I came in here with friends that I've had to turn on and say it to their face. And the fact that people in this house are trying to paint a narrative of me, Teddy, you, that I am untrustworthy, it just really, really upsets me. The only time I have not been transparent with you in this game, the only time is when you were asking me questions that were not my place to say, which was inappropriate for me to be being asked anyway. But I did not tell you because at that time we didn't have an agreement. I didn't know you that well. But, like, I think that you should just be really, like, looking at the way, like, this is going to be perceived on the outside world because you have come into this house and it's a roller coaster. You never know from day to day which version of Chris Kirkpatrick we're going to get. One day you'll be nice and hanging out and singing with me and complimenting my voice and cheering me on and I feel very close to you. And the next day, I've never experienced that from somebody that you will just like pay me dust and not speak to me. And then I have to be the person that keeps coming and initiating conversations with you. When we went up into the HOH room that you called me in, I already knew where you stood on the Mariah thing. When everybody was upstairs in the room talking about shit that we shouldn't have even been talking about on the live feeds because for protection of you and your legacy and your family and your well-being, your reputation, Shayna didn't stand up for you. Lamar didn't stand up for you. No one stood up for you in that room but me. I didn't say to anybody that you should be targeted because of that. I said we should not talk about that on camera because that has nothing to do with the reason why she should be going. And this is what we should be saying to protect Chris. Like, that's the person that you want on your team, not fucking Shayna. She didn't give a fuck. She just sat there and was like, well, whatever. I didn't come here to discuss that. I'm like, great, but it's being discussed. And if he's on our team, then we have to protect him far beyond this game. Nobody in this house, not even Misha, was doing that for you but me. I was the only person in here doing that. And so I just feel like also when I came up into the room, like I was like, great. For my game, it didn't make sense to send Mariah out. But if you were HOH, I was going to honor that. Mm-hmm. For you to have the audacity to tell me that if I were to hypothetically in the future potentially win an HOH and that if I didn't take out the person that you wanted me to on my HOH, which I would have never like held you down to that type of stipulation, like that was an unfair thing to say. I didn't say, like when we were in the room, Misha is the one that was like, I think for Todrick, he kind of feels like this.